Thank you so much. 5,000 subscribers, that is an amazing milestone. And for this reason, I thought that I should create a video that explains Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, how to set it up and how to get started with it. In many of my amazing videos where we see some amazing automations, I jump straight into Microsoft Power Automate. And in the comments, I see that you would like me to show a little bit more about how to set it up properly, how to get it, and how to get started with it. In addition to this, in this video, we are going to do a really cool process at the end of the video where we are going to extract some information from a web page. Now, that is super cool because we're going to be doing everything from beginning. Let's get started immediately and see what kind of system requirements and how do we install Microsoft Power Automate Desktop. So to install Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, you should visit this link right here. I will leave the link in the description down below. Now you can download the installer like this, or you can download it from the Microsoft Store. So on your Windows machine, you can search for the Microsoft Store and you can search for Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and install it that way. In addition to installing it, it is going to also install two plugins, one for Google Chrome and one for any other browser. So it could be Edge or Firefox, whichever browser you are using. The system requirements, if you want to use this automation tool, Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, they are very straightforward. You need a processor that is 1 GHz and you need storage of 1 GB and RAM of 2 GB. However, you also require a Microsoft account. You need a Microsoft machine also. It is not possible to run it from Mac. However, there are workarounds that you can do to run this Microsoft Power Automate from a Mac, but I will leave that in another video. So if you are on a Microsoft machine, you can follow along and install Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and get started with me right away. Now, once you install Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and you set it up with your account, you will be greeted with a page that looks just like this. On the welcome screen, you will have some very useful examples on how you can get started already by yourself. And also, I suggest using these examples that are provided with Microsoft Power Automate Desktop as basic templates for any process that you would like to build. We will see that later on in the video. Also, you have some tutorials that you can also use and watch to get started and to learn a little bit more in detail about Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, which is a great platform that allows to automate pretty much anything. There are other useful links such as a community forum and documentation about the platform and any other blog articles and articles that they release. Now, that is on your home page. After that, you have your flows right here. This is where you are going to be seeing all of the different flows that you have created. In my example, I have created hundreds of different flows, but you, after installing it, you will have a blank page. In addition to that, there is also a examples page. On the examples page, we have different automations that have been pre-built and pre-shipped with the installation that can allow us to get started quickly if we need to do some of those things. So let's take a look, for example, as desktop automation and see what kind of automations there are. So we could run an application, we could send text to Notepad, we could copy files, find and delete empty files, open a folder, and so on. All of these automations have been created in following best standard guidelines so that we can use these to get started with our own process. All we would have to do is create a copy of this process and build our process on top of this if we need some additional functionalities. Now, to go back to the automations, I will just click on the menu and I will be back at the different automations. Now, just a couple of more things that you should be aware of. Now, right here in the top right part of the panel, you will see a couple of menu icons. Now, these are useful to configure in the beginning, so you should configure the keyboard controls that you will use to stop a running automation. Now, once you launch an automation, the automation might be going really fast, it might be opening different tabs, it might be launching, sending keyword text. So you need a way that you can stop that automation in a quick way. Now, to do that, in this example, we are going to use Control, Shift, Alt, and T, and that is going to stop the automation that is currently running. One last thing to check out in the settings is the check for updates. Now, Microsoft Power Automate Desktop is going to pop up you for an update when there is one. However, if you want to check for them manually, there is a button to do that as well. In the help part, there is some information that is also found in the home, such as the learning, the tutorials, and the community, and so forth. Awesome. Are we ready to get started? Yes or no? I think yes. Let's create our first automation that is going to do something. Now, there is different ways that we can build our first automation. As I told you, we can start from an example. So if we want to build a automation that is for the web, we would go for a web automation. Now, I can create a new flow from scratch, but let's create a flow using one of these processes that is already a best practice. So the first thing that probably in our automation is going to be open a web page. So I'm going to start with the simplest process that there is, opening a web page. Let's create a copy of this process and let's name it open a web page training process. This is going to be our first robot, our first automation that is going to do something useful. Once our process has been created, we can edit our process. Now, there is a couple of icons here that I want to go over. Now, right here, we can launch our process. We can edit the edit and enter inside of our process. We can rename the name. We can create another copy if we wanted to. We can delete it and we can see the details of this process. Now, the details of this process is going to be a description, so that once we create different processes, we have a description that is going to describe what this process is about. It is something useful to have regarding every process. Now, to edit our process, we can just click on the edit button. This is going to bring up another window that is going to pop up where we are going to be able to edit our process. And just one more time, I want to thank you all for listening and for wanting to learn automation. Automation is a great skill that many people are going to require in the coming times, because it is highly required from companies. And also, it will allow you to save loads and loads of time. So why not learn it? And give yourself a thumbs up for wanting to learn it. All right, enough of that. Let's go back to our automation. Right here, we have our basic process that has been created for us from a template. Now, there is loads of things. Looks confusing, but it is not very confusing. Let's go over this process very quickly and easily. The first thing in this process is some comments. So we can insert comments to describe what we're doing. It is good practice. It might make it look confusing, but it is good practice to add comments inside of your flows so that you know exactly what is supposed to happen and what is happening. And also, when you give it to somebody else, they will also know what is happening. The next action right here, and why I say action is because right here we have an actions panel. Now, this actions panel is all of the different things that we can create. Now, think of these all of different actions, like, for example, opening a web page, clicking on a button, extracting some data, getting data from a PDF, merging two Excel files, and hundreds of other actions like this. All of these actions are grouped into categories right here, but we can also search for them right here. So, for example, we don't have to know, we can also, it's very intuitive. So if we wanted to do something with text, we would just type in text and see all of the different text actions that there are under every category. Now, those are the actions, and the actions are going to be the main components of our process. Right here, we're going to be building our automation or our process, however we want to call it, and we're going to be dragging and dropping different actions in here to do different things. Now, on the other side, on the right side, we have other things such as variables, and variables are going to be containers and places where we're going to hold information from our process. Now, there are other things such as UI elements. So these are elements on an application or on a web page that we are going to interact with our automation. And finally, we have images, and these are going to be the different images that we can use also in our automation. So we can create a robot that clicks on different images. So, for example, on a we can take a picture of a button and have the robot click on that picture, finding it inside of a web page. All right, let's test our process and see what happens. To run our process, we have to go to this bar right here and click on the run button. This is going to trigger our process and make it run. So the first thing is the action that is asking us to insert a link to a web page. Now we're gonna put Google and we're gonna open our website. And right here we are on Google. So our process has worked successfully. We have opened a Microsoft Edge web page. There was this condition that was executed. So this condition would check that we pressed the button okay, or that we pressed the button cancel. And then it would open this Microsoft Power Automate desktop page. After this, I could do a whole set of different actions, such as extracting information from a web page, inserting information in a web page, and so forth. One final thing that I want to add to this video about how to use Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, how to set it up, and how to get started with it, is this pane right down here in the bottom. So right here we have the different actions that we have in this process. We have one subflow, we have one selected action, and we have a delay. This is the speed that we can use to run our process. And also we can notice right here in the variables that we have some variables that have been created for us. If we click on the first action, we're going to see that there is different things that we can insert to configure this input variable, input action. All of these things, there is no code required. They're all pretty much self-explanatory. We can also see that right here in the bottom, there is a variable that are produced, and that is URL and button pressed. So this is the button pressed, it's okay, and the URL is the Google variable that we inserted. Once we go to the other action, which is the launch Microsoft Edge, we see the initial URL is the variable that we have inserted, and that is why we're opening on that variable. And every time we launch this process, we can insert a new web page and open a new web page. Obviously, after that, we will do a whole other set of actions, but I will leave that for the following video. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. Give yourself again a high five and a thumbs up for wanting to learn automation, and also wanting to learn it with Microsoft Power Automate, which is a free tool available on any Microsoft Microsoft machine, which is great. However, there are some limitations regarding robots, meaning that you might not be able to run your robots with a unattended mode. However, for all of the different things that I show in my videos, we can use Microsoft Power Automate Desktop. Thank you so much for watching, ladies and gentlemen, and I will see you in the next video.